Yeah, well, I mean, meeting someone like Ginger, seeing those shows, you can tell it, she really doesn't care what people, she'll be herself. And I think that's always an important thing to see in any musician or any icon that you have. And growing up in the South and, not being able to be yourself is hard. And I think you always connect with, if you go to big cities, you meet people like Ginger. It's really easy to connect with someone like that. And it's important. And I think that people like Ginger, when they just are who they are, even if it's in a punk band that's humorous or whatever it is, as long as you're being somewhat transgressive, then you're doing something good.
Yeah, I mean, I had to go through the same thing that you went through in the Midwest, and it was probably a lot worse than for me because I'm 2 or 3 years older than you, but it was tough. And then when I came out, here, I was still kind of real young and a kind of a babe in Toyland and didn't know the freedom that I could find because I never felt it by being in the Midwest. And then you get involved with more creative people, and you see people that are just totally like, when I came out to San Francisco, it was the Tubes. And maybe I read about them in Roxy or something, but I'd never seen them until, with Fee Wavell, with the We Were White Punks on Dope and stuff like that. That was just like mind-blowing, and you see, and then you see the angels of light walking around on quaaludes and stuff and all that stuff. And the same way when you come down to Hollywood. Now, Hollywood during the 80s was very, very repressed, and they had Daryl Gates, that was the police chief, and he would pick you up for jaywalking. You'd have to spend like a week in jail for that. And they would pick you up and ask you for your ID, and they'd say, "Oh, you don't have an ID," and they'd rip it up, and they'd take it, they arrest you for that. It was a real tough, very, very hardcore scene in LA. It was not the way it is now. And there was a lot of prejudice, a lot of bigotry and everything, and especially against punk rockers. And there was little mecca places, and that was the Tropicana and the Continental Hyatt House, where you could go and you could just, that was home. They just make you feel so good. There was an airline called Continental Airlines, and you used to be able to do the midnight flight from LA to San Francisco for $11.
That's crazy.
We'd be at the airport. We'd all bring champagne, there would be quaaludes, and it was like everybody, from the Tubes to I think even David Johansen and Sylvain from the New York Dolls were on those flights.